There is some good news for home brewers who would like to make this EasyBITX now for two bands, for 20 and 40 meter bands. We have a new firmware that has been done by Mr. Nathan Williams, VU2 GAO, for this EasyBITX. Now it is possible to make EasyBITX for two bands, for 20 and 40 meter bands. So currently what you see in this video is 40 meter bands, and we also have the facility of a blinking tower where you see that the software is working, which is indicated by a blinking sign. We also have LSB and USB. If you see on the top left hand side where it is written LS, that basically is LSB. And we also have an S meter facility. Presently we don't have this hardware connected to this AO0 pin of Arduino Nano. So once we do that, this S meter also will be showing working. But the code has been incorporated into the firmware, and all these new features are operational. Now we'll see how we need to change this band to 20 meter band. So just with a double click on the encoder, we'll get 20 meter band. So here we are. So now we are on 14 megahertz, 20 meter band. So the setup is quite good. The firmware is written very nicely. It's very smooth. Presently my setup is not set up for two bands. The firmware is, but my transceiver is band pass filters, low pass filters are not set up for two bands. So basically this is a demo of the firmware only incorporated into this hardware. So once I do that, once I do make the low pass filters and band pass filters for both the bands, then I would give a demo again. But anyone wishing to build this EasyBITX for two bands can do it now very easily. So here we are on 40 meter band. This is connected. So the hardware, basically my set is, presently my set is made for 40 meters. So this band is working. So we have tuned it from 7 megahertz to 7.3. Here you see, it's going up to 7.3. I can also change the steps. 01 hertz, 10 hertz, 100 hertz, 1K, 10K. So here is it. Now you can easily make this EasyBITX for two bands. My compliments and thanks to to Mr. Nathan William for making this possible and making this very useful firmware so that it can help people make easy BITX for two bands. In fact, if you have got old BITX PCBs or kits, so you could download the code from our website and use this code for making your old BITX for two bands. So I welcome all of you to try to make this easy BITX transceiver. The kits and PCBs are available on our website for Indian hams. They are available from inkits.in, and for DX hams they are available from they are available from amateurradiokits.in. These boards also will be available from our eBay store. So thank you and enjoy the new firmware.